Home sales have been hotter than a volcano on the sun here in the Twin Cities, at least until the last 2 months, that is. The number of houses sold has declined in that time. Is it finally a buyer's market? The answer is yes, but the answer is also no. What? Let's try to explain.
That chill in the air, that's called fall, as in falling number of houses sold.
There is a little bit of a change that's happened the last couple of months. We've seen year on year a slight reductions in the number of sales.
That's Cap Hemmersing, incoming president of the Minneapolis Area Association of Realtors and knower of all things housing. The number of houses sold may be down, but Hemmersing says the sale price of those homes is up.
With pricing on the rise, you might think that's a little bit of a concern, but we've got interest rates that are unheard of, and that's been that way for some time. We've actually seen a little bit of a drop in interest rates. So for buyers, now is the time for them to be looking at making a purchase because we're in a little bit of a lull.
Okay, so it's a buyer's market.
On the other hand, sellers are in a great place. Overall, our marketplace has 2.5 months of inventory right now. So it should be very much in favor of sellers. And in some areas, in some segments of the market, it actually is that.
Never mind. Still a seller's market, right?
It is a little bit confusing. There's a lot of data here, right? And so we've got some areas where people are still receiving multiple offers for their property in certain price points. We also have some areas where it's very difficult.
At the risk of confusing your face off, we're going to continue. Grab a pencil, draw a flowchart, get some snacks. For some of you, it is a buyer's market. Low interest rates continue, and at some price points, there's plenty of inventory for you to choose from, which means the houses sit on the market longer, and you in turn can get a better price. But the seller's market continues too, especially in the starter home price range. There's so few houses in that bracket for sale that they go quickly and sell high.
Depending on your strategy for selling, your strategy for buying, depending on the marketplace you live in or want to purchase in, that's going to impact how much of an upper hand you might have in that negotiation or in that purchase.
In other words, what is one man's buyer's market is another man or women's seller's market. Kath has advice for you both.
What I would advise sellers to do is make sure that they've prepared their house properly for sale. Make sure that they're showing it at its best and make sure that your price is competitive. I would not wait for spring for more inventory to come available, because now is the time where you maybe have a little bit more time to think. Now is the time where interest rates are good.
All right.
That was extremely depressing.
I know, because you have been in a buyer's land.
I've been in buyer's mode for like 10 years in the starter home sector.
Yeah.
I've bought out.
And I've watched it happen. You show me a house and it's already got six offers on it before you can
that
even click on
was.
It. I know. So there is no good news for you at this point, apparently.
Awesome. That's the story of my life.
New construction is up, though, which is awesome, except it's not in any of the areas where millennials or boomers want to be. So it just depends. It's so weird. It's just one of those weird times where it's depending on where you are in your life and what you're looking for, it could be a buyer's or a seller's market. So, sorry.
Moving in with you. Moving
on. We have plenty of room.